friends, welcome. My name is Miss Liz, and I'm the Director of Children's Ministry for Baylake United Methodist Church. I'll be here today on November 29th to talk to you about our children's sermon. And so today is a very special day. Today is the first day of Advent. Now, Advent is a pretty big word that we don't use that often, but Advent is Latin for coming. And so Advent is a big deal to us Christians because we are celebrating the fact that somebody is coming soon. Do you know who it is? It's not Santa Claus. It's Jesus. Jesus came to earth in order to save us from our sins and for us to know how much he loves us. Now, God sent us Jesus so that we could have a deep and personal relationship with him and that we can know how much God loves us. So the arrival of Jesus changed the world for many people. But today we're going to talk about how Jesus changed the lives of the wise men who went looking for him. Now the wise men saw a star in the sky and they followed it. And these men were considered to be very rich and powerful. And their title, Magi, lets us know that they were very important. But they were searching for something and they were searching for hope. The wise men traveled from the east and they followed the star they saw in the sky. Okay, so I have a fun way that we can remember Jesus and the wise men and the star throughout our everyday. Do you like apples? I like to eat apples with my lunch. And a fun way we can think about the wise men and the star is by taking an apple and slicing it right down the middle. So when we slice our apple right down the middle, we see that on the inside, there's a star. Do you see that? Do you see the star? Well, that helps us think about Jesus every day, and we can celebrate that the wise men were smart enough to seek out Jesus in their lives, and we can try to do the same. Let's search for Jesus everywhere we go. When the wise men left their home, they probably traveled hundreds of miles to search for Jesus. Matthew 2 says they came to Jerusalem and asked where the King of the Jews was. They said, "We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." They knew the star was a symbol for a king, but who would have guessed that king would have been born in a manger? In this world, it's very easy for us to become caught up in material things. It happens to a lot of people at Christmas time, in fact. They think about presents under the tree instead of the present the wise men found under the star. What we want to do at Christmas is think more about Jesus and less about what Santa may bring. We hear in the Bible from Matthew 2, when the wise men left Jerusalem, the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. The wise men were overjoyed when they saw the star. That star led them right to Jesus, and Jesus is the hope of the world. Matthew 2 also says, on coming to the house, they saw the child who was with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Through worshiping Jesus, the wise men found hope. In the dark sky of the night, the wise men found light. We can find hope in this challenging time by the light Jesus gives our world. So what I want you to do this year is think less about the presents that you may find under the tree and think more about the presents that the wise men found under the star. That present is Jesus. And with Jesus, we can have hope throughout any circumstance. I pray that you are healthy and safe and that you had a wonderful Thanksgiving. I pray that you will join us next week, whether in person or online, for our children's sermon. And let your parents know that if you want to make an Advent wreath, we have bags for them, and they can either pick them up at the church or let me know and I can drop it off to you. May God bless you and keep you safe. I'll see you next week. Bye.